in no way excuses them from their dereliction of duty or possible criminal acts or leaving a house alone, allegedly alone, with our dog there with their own pit bull pack. It's insane. Insane. And she's still running operations. So I want the city attorney to get down there, get to the court, get an emergency order posted on her property that she cannot board dogs there, because had that been done 2 years ago, our dog would still be alive.
Okay. Very good.
Well, it's a darn good thing we have a criminal case number in Libby's mauling death, because we're dealing with a convicted felon in the first place. Christina Robinson, you killed the most beautiful thing that Elisa and I have ever known. And then you have the nerve to smirk at me in City Hall and to mouth the words sad to Elisa when we were seated. Now, you never gave us a formal apology. You never gave us any insurance information when we requested it until weeks later after we had to hire an attorney. And even then, you gave up the wrong policy number. You want sad, honey? I'll bring you sad. Wait for it. This is our new family. Elisa, Fang, Pepper, and me. We are truly blessed to be together, but the occasion of such blessing is the ugliest single experience of our adult lives. Livy was mauled to death and killed because Precious Paws owner Christina Robinson left our dogs alone in the company of her pack, including several pit bulls. Livy was a young American, full of life and love like no other dog I've ever met in my 51 years on this planet. Elisa would tell you the same thing. And we rescued her, and we gave her all the love we could. She gave it back to us, and it showed. Libby loved us with complete abandon. We'll never forget how she would wake us up in the morning and pin us down to lick our faces while we laughed hysterically, or how she would snuggle between us, fully extended like a human, with her head between ours on the pillow as we contemplated our next playtime or journey or mountain bike ride. And Libby was happy and smiling every single day that she got to spend with us, and so were we. Now every time I wake up, it's the 3-second rule. I have 3 seconds before the gravity of losing Libby to a violent and needless death hits me and surrounds me much like a giant storm cloud for much of the day. I cry every day. Her death will not be in vain, however, and the people who have lied to us or in any way conspired to cover up the truth will be outed, and that includes Christina's buddy Patty Angeles from Valhalla. She showed up recently to actually tell Elisa and me that it was our fault for not double-checking on the facility and that we were somehow 50-50 at fault for Libby's death. Yeah, right? Well, if that's the case, then why'd you give her a dog? Nova, you know, the one that killed our Livy. You didn't tell me that, Patty. I had to get it from the industry and confront you with it. Slippery, aren't you?
Now then, dear Officer McKee, you are quite correct regarding your email last month to Edmonds Animal Control Officer Shoemake. You know, you're right. Sometimes I just can't stay out of it. Now remember, were it not for my meddling and intervention in the first place, we'd be devoid of a necropsy for Livy anyway. So that was because I asserted our position. That's the only reason we got one. Okay, and I think that's important to remember. Now, my concerns remain valid, and I'm deeply concerned that the city has bent itself over backward to avoid taking the approach I noted in the Massachusetts mauling from last fall, in which they shut down the kennel pending a criminal investigation after a mauling death there. Now, Ms. Bronstein and I reiterated that point to City Council this week, but apparently no one cares about the ongoing danger enough to actually get a court order and to post signs to really shut them down immediately, even though there is a per se legal violation in a non-conforming use. Okay, as a former zoning project manager, I can't say that any clearer than that. Even a layperson can understand that, okay? So I guess crime pays at Mountlake Terrace. It's unreal. Yes, we are emotional. That does not, by any means, render us irrational. That is a distinction with a difference. Just ask the folks at Hanover, Mass, as noted in the links I've provided. Now, they have a criminal hearing coming up on the 24th next week. That's all I can say on that case right now. They're moving forward. Now, further, just so we all know, in addition to being, you know, a convicted felon, she's got a proved track record of leaving dogs alone and in dangerous situations. Yet the response from City Attorney Schrag was almost dismissive of those concerns. Wow! You know, at any rate, I'm not going to produce the DUI information on Miss Robinson because the DUI is not defined as a crime of moral turpitude that would also bear on her credibility, per se. Okay, but this complaint below from her former neighbor, her commercial neighbor, definitely bears on her ability to care for dogs. So, thus, as to Attorney Schrag's comment denying an imminent risk, he misspelled imminent, by the way, the criminal investigation is still open, and there are facts that are undetermined at this point, including provocation, he says. Therefore, in my view, the facts would not rise to a level sufficient to obtain an emergency abatement order, since I do not see this as an imminent life or safety issue that exists for the community or a neighborhood. Okay. That's end quote. Now, how can he say that with a straight face? First of all, provocation is irrelevant. Regardless of which dog started the fight, the fact remains that Christina is continuing to put those dogs in dangerous situations, as other dog handlers have noted to me on multiple occasions since I went public.
Send your name and address for us.
We'll do the split thing like we did last time.
Okay, we can do both.
So my name is Elisa Bronstein, 17006 11th Avenue Northeast in Shoreline.
And I'm Christopher King of the same address.
Okay.
May it please the council. I've been wondering for some time about a certain passage in one of Christina Robinson's writings to her clients. And after reviewing it, it makes her own letter appear to make a tacit admission that she has left dogs alone on prior occasion and that an injury occurred. So one of her many moles in her organization, she calls it, has informed us of this, that that was what she told them. So obviously it's hearsay, but if it came from her, it's not hearsay. So in her letter, which is from her, that was sent to some of her clients, she writes, "Naturally, describing the situation in which our dog was mauled and killed, she says, naturally, it turned to anger and frustration, which it should have. And then she says, I made a choice that, yes, I made it before, but this time it ended in not a wound, but a death. And I didn't get that the first time I read it, but now after this source told us that Christina had told her that there was a prior injury, now it tends to make sense. Okay? So, and then she says, there's nothing I can do to fix it, but I told them I'd do anything. I love that dog as much as my own, blase, blase. Okay. I might suggest, if you love your own dog, you don't leave it unattended, especially with bully breeds. Okay? That's just a matter of common sense.
Now let's stop right there. We love all dogs, don't get it twisted, okay? Elisa House sits my friend's dog, Sweet Pea, and said dog is also an ace Saab mechanic, apparently. Likes to work in my cars. Moreover, whenever we've watched dogs, we make sure they actually get run as promised in the yard. And we're not hiding them because we don't want the neighbors to know we're running an illegal operation, okay? And when we leave, we lock them up in these things they call crates. Dave was running and stuff.
This person who informed us also claimed that she telephoned the city on more than one occasion to warn of dangerous dogs and children and was told that we won't do anything until something happens. Well, now something more has happened. We've lost our best friend. Okay? And, you know, in my opinion, especially if this is true, that there was a prior attack, or if it's also true that one of her dogs had attacked their pet rabbit, especially if either of those things are true, that's criminal conduct, exposing another animal to a dangerous animal, okay, a known dangerous entity, all right? You can't cover up a dangerous dog. And who told her to put down Bullet? She is claiming on Facebook that she put down Bullet, which to my knowledge is their least favorite pit bull, okay? But she implies that we told her to put it down. We don't have any ultimatum in this. Our lawyers working over here, as you know, our lawyers submitted an information request from you. I have no say who puts down Bullet. I don't know why she was put down, he or she. I don't know if Bullet's a man or a female, I don't know. But, you know, who counseled her on that? Was it the city? I don't know. We'll get into that later. Not to mention this, but the stated rationale for keeping Libby and Fang at their home as opposed to bringing them in to the daycare where they're supposed to be exercised as was advertised was completely ridiculous and false. And it proves that she shouldn't be anywhere around dogs, in my opinion. She wrote that Fang is an older tripod who doesn't get around well. Fang is too. He's quite sprightly. He gets around very well. I've submitted videos on YouTube where the guy jumps on couches, he's running around, he's fine. And then the other excuse was that Libby is high-strung. Well, that's somewhat true. She's a sporting breed. Of course they're high-strung, especially when they don't get the exercise that we were paying her to provide. She was being kept at home, and their own videos from their own facility, the brick and mortar, which was licensed, unlike the house, their own videos from the 2 days before Libby died don't show Libby in them. Okay, so that's prima facie evidence that she wasn't there. So she's keeping our dog at the house with her father, who I don't know what his exact condition is, but he does not appear to be, you know, fully there in some way. He seems to have a disability of some kind. I don't know exactly what it is. I understand.
But more importantly, we never met him, and that was not who we hired to watch our dogs.
Exactly. And to be in a house with children and the dogs, when we now know from the city reports that he lost a dog 2 years ago and didn't even know it. And that dog, ironically, was a German wire-haired pointer, whereas ours was a German short-haired pointer. So, we didn't sign up for any of this. Okay, it's deceitful, it's fraudulent, in my opinion. Fraud in the fact of fraudulent inducement, and possibly criminal. Okay, so, something's fishy in Denmark. Something stinks around here, and it's not us. Okay, so, my question, again, to you, though, is why the delay in shutting her down pending investigation? You know, you could have done that the day after we appeared in council when I was here, when we were here the last time. And it could have been done any time in the last 2 years since the cease and desist letter was sent to them. Okay?
In September of 2014.
Right, at any point in time. Now since that time, there's been about $250,000 in fines that she owes the city for running an illegal operation. This is serious business. And our dog is dead because of this. All right, so it's like a but-for cause. Had they been shut down, Libby wouldn't be dead right now because she wouldn't have been at the house. So, the one other thing, too. I found some comments on social media from one of her supporters who showed up online to say that it was our fault because we didn't do enough due diligence, okay? I was a zoning professional, one of my jobs as an attorney, and, you know, I already have that guilt of my own for not coming to the city to review myself. And I told that woman, I'll carry that guilt to the day I die, that I didn't research these people and find out that they weren't even legal here. Okay, that's on me. But in no way excuses them from their dereliction of duty or possible criminal acts or leaving a house alone, allegedly alone, with our dog there with their own pit bull pack. It's insane. Insane. And she's still running operations. So I want the city attorney to get down there, get to the court, get an emergency order posted on her property that she cannot board dogs there, because had that been done 2 years ago, our dog would still be alive.
Okay. Very good.
So to follow that up, some of you were not here last time we were here 2 weeks ago, and I believe in that packet, although there's been a flurry of information, so it's hard to keep it all straight. But we found a case that happened not too long ago in, was it Hanover?
Yes, Hanover,
in Hanover, Massachusetts, which actually we used to live not far from there at all, and where a similar situation happened. I don't think that this is the first time, and it won't be the last time that something like this tragedy has occurred. I'm not, you know, devoid of that knowledge. However, I do feel that it's our duty to do better, because if you're not learning, you're not living, and that's how I live my life. So now, after doing research on other cases, they shut that kennel down the day that the dog's body was retrieved so that they could do a proper investigation. And I feel strongly that this woman has gotten away with quite literally murder. And I'm done. I'm done with excuses. I'm done reading pages and pages and pages of her ramblings about, oh, that dog got out on my watch, but I found it. Oh, that dog ran away when my dad was home, but we got it back. I'm done, and you should be too. I am just completely dismayed by the lack of caring. These animals don't have a voice. This is up to us, and I believe strongly. I didn't know that I was an animal activist until December 29th when my dog died. And this has changed the entire trajectory of our lives.
In our careers, we will be dog advocates now.
So to sum this up, I have a few questions. I understand, I did email, you had mentioned that you can't respond when we're here and we sign up. I did email to let you know that we would be here tonight. So I'm just gonna put these out there. We can certainly email these questions to you folks as well. We are gonna require a response of some sort. We've heard boo from the city for weeks now, and we need some answers. Firstly, I'd like to know from whomever is conducting the post-mortem work on our dog, which I believe would be with Animal Control, Officer McKee, perhaps. But when do we anticipate that the post-mortem will be completed on Libby? Number two, I'd like to know why the city attorney has not sought an emergency order to post signs at her residence and potentially even at her brick and mortar in Edmonds, Washington, while she's continuing to run this illegal operation. Number three, do you plan to seek the $250,000 owed to the taxpayers for the cumulative fines that the city referenced in the cease and desist letter issued to Ms. Robinson more than 2 years ago? Number four, is the city maintaining jurisdiction over the dogs? Her particular pack consisted of four dogs, and to our knowledge, they were all assessed the night of the event after we called the police and animal control to show up. And number five, did anyone under the city's auspices recommend or order that her dog, her youngest pit mix, Bullet, be put down? Because if not, I'd like to know who did, knowing that there was a pending case and an open investigation on her business. And lastly, and perhaps most importantly, I'd like to know how we can work with you to get Ms. Robinson running her business in an honest and true fashion. Thank you for your time.
If I may briefly, I don't want her to run her business in an honest and true fashion anymore. I want her shut down. And I will bear no compunction to say that. I want her shut down. And one other thing about that woman who wrote me, who was telling me that it was my fault for not researching it up, I forgot to mention that. Come to find out that someone tipped me off. She was the one who dealt Nova, the dog that killed Libby, to Ms. Robinson. She didn't disclose that either. I had to find out, and I confronted her with it, and she says, oh yeah, I did provide her that dog. So even her supporters are slippery. It has to end. Thank you.